Crumble's main ministry is to the body of Christ, and that's to really encourage Christians to keep Jesus first.
Our music is aimed at reaching the youth, give them an alternative to what they're listening to now.
And we just feel that it's our place as a ministry to put them back, you know, in that position where they have Jesus as their first love.
As far as the ministry is concerned, we're seeing people come to the Lord almost every concert. We're seeing many people every concert rededicate their lives. And that's enough confirmation for me to know that ministry is valid.
I really dig playing it. I really like to play music, and I really like it a lot. But more important, I'm serving the Lord while I'm doing it, and He just granted me the privilege of being able to do something I like and to serve Him at the same time.
Changed our goals a little bit. We used to be pretty much church oriented. We were going to a church and do a concert and play a lot of soft music and try to please everybody. But the Lord's kind of led us over this time period to move more towards high school and college age kids, and we go in and basically do a Christian rock concert instead of something that pleases the old people and the young kids. And we're just more specialized now as far as our music, and we're reaching a lot of high school and college kids that are really into rock music and things of the world, and they're getting turned on to the Lord through the vehicle of Christian rock, and that's real exciting for us to see, because it kind of changed our lives over the past few years.
Previously in some bands where we played in bars and things like that, and you know that I just get so much more out of playing Christian music. I get to play my instrument. I'm the drummer. I get to play my instrument for the Lord. I don't play it for entertainment. I'm playing it for the Lord, and I'm playing it so that people can see how my life has changed, that I'm there for a purpose. You know, I tell you, we don't make much money, you know, a lot of times in a Christian band, but I tell you, when you see kids stand up for the Lord and accept the Lord, and you see kids' lives change, to me, that's better than any wallet full of money, you know, in the world.
It's hard sometimes. You live out of a suitcase for 6 months at a time, seems like, but you meet a lot of people, and I don't think we'd see the country a better way if we weren't doing this. And the most rewarding thing is that we know that we're serving God with exactly what He wants us to do. And that's enough reward in itself.
Bus repairs. Well,
what do we hate them?
Yeah, it's necessary. It's a constant battle.
Bus repairs are always real complicated. Stuff's real big and real heavy. Got to have big tools to get the job done. 65% of what we do, we ain't supposed to be doing anyway. Supposed to have a big garage do it or something. Just like this radiator here. This here's typical of specialized large type tools we have to have for disassembling buses.
I think it's supposed to be this one.
Oh. This here's typical of the large type of tools we have to have for disassembling buses. This is another piece of specialized equipment that you won't find in everybody's toolbox.
Hi, Mom. Right now we're on a 5-week tour to California. We left
New Jersey a couple days ago, stopped in Virginia out of college, and we'll be out there. We go to, well, where are we in? Arkansas now, right? Arkansas? We lose it every day. We're in a different state. Arkansas, then Kansas, then California, then back through Idaho and Colorado. And we just got back from 8 weeks in Florida and a couple weeks in the studio, so we always keep going. We get a couple weeks off now and then to relax.
Making music with my